They're all going golden, and here comes the bullet time to surrender the game. A quadra kill. FBI is on the run, and they're gonna give it to him. The floodlight
over the wall, trying to get the autos down. Speb on a rampage through the enemy team, though. The chaser moving forward. Has he gone too far? The answer is yes.
Triple kill
for Speb. Quadra kill. Is that gonna be the
pentakill? Kill?
He does not go down. Braga's really under pressure. Legendary Alex just finds 1, 2, 3, 4. Is it going to be 5? I can't actually tell. Everyone is dead. And it is the pentakill.
ショットバラジーダメージが入った。ごめんか、暴れる波。体力は全体的に低いんですが、まだデッドしていない。まずは1人取った。2人取った。アバメンまだ暴れる。3人取った。バロンまでステールした。アバメンクアドラ。アバメンベッタ。
ペンタキル。
アペンタキル。
I'm Sjokz and welcome back to Ultimate List, home of LoL Esports' craziest and most legendary moments of all time. This week, we are focusing on the play that all carries dream about. That magical moment when you throw your team on your back and delete all the enemy players by yourself, otherwise known as the pentakill.
Zero Marin is huge, literally, because that wild growth. Hootie manages to catch Faker with his ultimate, but Faker back away. Fnatic in big trouble, double kill for Bang Ready. Make it a triple kill. And now SK Telecom, despite that big up for Bebevin.
Bang's going in.
Oh, Bebevin near Penta. That's a pentakill, I believe.
Yes, it is.
Pentakills turn League of Legends from a team game into a one-man show. It's a play where for one moment, a player becomes the center of attention with everyone's eyes focused on them to pull off something great. So without further ado, and in no particular order, here are the five greatest pentakills in LoL Esports history. When Deft joined the reigning LPL champions EDG in 2015, he entered the region with an expectation to win. And win he did, conquering the LPL in his very first split, though his path to victory was far from easy. In the finals, Deft faced LGD, which featured his former teammate Acorn and longtime Samsung sister team rival Imp. To no one's surprise, the finals went all five games, thanks in part to both AD carries' extremely aggressive play.
But he can't make it in time.
They've committed all five members to
Deft, what? Going so deep in onto Akon, gets the solo kill by flashing on top of his head.
And in game five, Deft's aggression won EDG the final, stopping LGD's Baron attempt with a stunning pentakill.
It might not be enough here. Pawn needs to find a kill to win, but he QSS is out. Imp gets the kill. That's two kills. Deft goes back in, flashes aggressive. Pawn needs to hide away. Deft, what the hell? Gets a triple kill. Gets the quadra. Gets the pentakill. What on earth is going on?
LPL champion, MSI champion, Demacia Cup champion, and top eight at Worlds. I'd say 2015 was a pretty good year for Deft's career. It takes an enormous amount of skill to simply play Fiora well, let alone getting a pentakill with the duelist. But Suning top laner Bin accomplished just that at the 2020 World Championship Finals. Down one game to tournament favorites Damwon Gaming, Suning placed their championship hopes on an unconventional strategy revolving around Bin's last pick Fiora and jungler SOFM's tank Rengar. And with the last pick, Bin showed us that LPL Fioras truly are just built different, capping off an amazing top lane carry performance by becoming the first player ever to get a pentakill in the World Championship Finals.
Cannot interrupt anyone else. He's being chipped
the
away.
Start.
Melted. He's down. He's dead. That's it. Canyon's finished as well. SOFM hops forward. Ghost flashes defensively and rooted in place. Bin sends him
penta.
Ghost gets caught out. That's the quadra. Looking for it. Bin will pick it up. Get the pentakill for Bin and Suning Gaming in the World Championship Finals.
Jumping back a year to the 2019 World Championship quarterfinals, Griffin AD Carry Viper found himself one game away from elimination against the reigning champs Invictus Gaming. Failing to carry game two despite a massive early lead as Zaya, Viper got the chance to run it back with the marksman, with Griffin betting on the bot lane star to keep them in the tournament. And just like in game two, Viper dominated the early game, but this time he and Griffin didn't throw that lead. This time he took the game into his own hands.
Where'd they go? They might have knocked him down, puts down the pool, but is there enough damage? They're gonna try. They're ult over the top, but it's already a 2-0. Viper doesn't die, but one finally comes through. It's up to Jackie Love, but he gets stunned. Clutch
shots from Tarzan, but Morgana can't find it either. Viper stays alive. That's the full pentakill.
Beginning the fight without Chovy, Viper beautifully dodged IG's barrage of attacks, first avoiding Qiyana's ult with his Featherstorm, then denying Lee Sin's engage with a stopwatch. Thanks to Tarzan's Elise Cocoon, Viper could then slay rival carry Jackie Love, just barely surviving with Cleanse to complete the Penta. When you think of Uzi, it's hard not to remember his legendary Vayne, which made fans across the world fall in love with the AD carry many years ago.
Cool, gonna go over towards Sammy. There's a Stan United being used very early. Uzi is coming in from the backside. Surprise, here comes the Vayne. Kill for White. Sam's not gonna escape this one. They focus down Uzi, but look at him. He's still alive. He's still surviving. He stays alive.
Looking at Uzi's long list of Vayne highlights, it's no wonder he's become forever linked with the champion. And among that stack of plays is his epic 1v3 pentakill from the 2014 LPL Summer Split. Collapsed on by three members of IG mid after taking down Zatai and Kitties, Uzi first dodged Gragas' explosive cask, then perfectly flashed over Jarvan's Cataclysm after killing Lucian while tanking the enemy turret. With IG's cooldowns burned, Uzi capped off an incredible outplay with some beautiful kiting to secure the Penta. For the final spot on this list, we asked you, the viewers, what the most epic pentakill was in LoL Esports history. And you guys posted some incredible moments, like Rakeen's huge Azir ace in CMB's unbelievable Game 5 comeback, Reckless hopping across mid lane in his first finals after rejoining Fnatic in 2015, and Doublelift's epic Jinx pentakill from his first ever LCS finals win.
He's looking for Bjergsen.
But there was one moment that was posted more than any other, and that's Cloud9 top laner Balls' oh-so-satisfying pentakill from the 2015 World Championship. See, heading into the World Championship group stage, Balls received a bunch of criticism for his Diamond 2 rank in solo queue. But like earlier in the year when Cloud9 made their miracle gauntlet run to Worlds, Balls silenced the critics by completely decimating Fnatic with the then newly reworked Darius.
There's a two-man ult, he catches Balls. Sneaky is out, there's a turret alive, but they gotta be careful. A big knockback, and that's the kill into Morgana. Azir goes down as well, but the Dunks are coming through. A double kill for Balls, a triple kill for
that's
Balls.
Nice.
Holy cow,
the
I don't know what's more satisfying, Balls getting that pentakill to earn Cloud9 their third consecutive group stage win, or his post-game interview right after.
After all the criticism you've had to bear with in the last couple of weeks, how did you manage to come strong into this game and even pull this off versus this team?
Well, all that Diamond 2 practice.
I'm Sjokz, and we've unfortunately reached the end of this week's episode of Ultimate List. But do you have a personal favorite pentakill that didn't make the list, or perhaps you have ideas for future episodes? Be sure to let us know in the comments down below or hit us up on Twitter at LoL Esports. Until next time!